that will help a bit, but no, no, the engine 2 failed, and Boeing, autopilot disconnect. Hello aviators, how are you today? My name is Magna Nordahl. I am an ATR instructor and I've flown this aircraft for 25 years. I'm in an ATR 72-600 simulator and I put it at 10,000 feet and approaching Dubai. And I will demonstrate something I hope you will never ever experience as a pilot. And that is a flame out on all engines. In this case, ATR has two engines, both will fail. I programmed the simulator to fail one at 9,500 feet and the other at 8,000. I also set up first off the switching for the attitude heading reference system and here the computer, which means I can use the autopilot for the remainder of the flight. So let's pretend and clear to descend, for example. 3,000 feet, and select vertical speed mode, 1,000 feet per minute should be good. We have Dubai in front, I put on the GoPro for a while, I'm running out of battery on the GoPro, but I can film a bit of it. Reduce speed, I forgot to reduce power. So the autopilot told me, watch out. Okay. I have Dubai Airport down on my side. And I will do this recording in one take. So you can see I'm not cheating. I'm really passing 9,005. Engine lost torque. And got a lot of alerts. And engine NH. Goes down, my memory actions will be, will probably be number one, to fly the idle. When energy is below 30%, yes, okay. I fed the propeller number one. That reduced the drag, the propeller will stop, and fuel shut off. I lost generator, bleed air, air condition one. Still no big panic, because I have still one engine. I will send a pan call to Dubai ATC and tell them I would like to land at the airport. And I'm already on a kind of a downwind and I think I will fly overhead. Let's see how that works. And first officer will go through the checklist, which I'm not going to do. I can increase power on the other engine, that would be a good idea. I can say max continuous thrust. That will help a bit, but no, no, the engine 2 failed and Boeing. Autopilot disconnect. And I lost my primary flight display. I had to trim the aircraft out. More failures. Display switching. Now I know I will have to reduce my speed so I can just maintain altitude more or less. I will cross overhead the airfield. Always fly first. And I will set manual target speed. Minimum speed is 130. I set 140. That's minimum maneuvering speed where I can use normally bank angle. Continue flying. And now to reduce drag, power lever number 2. That's all that for the landing gear. Funny. We feather and we'll shut off. Trim is okay. I crossed overhead the runway. I'm quite high. I'm approaching 6,000 feet. I will make a shallow turn. Maybe to this setting. I can, in fact, use the autopilot. Maybe 500 feet per minute in descent. There it is. I select auto, select a bow, so it will not level off against my will. I'm a bit close. I can go a little further out. And approaching 6,000, here is a rule of thumb. This aircraft has a glide ratio of close to 15 to 1. And that means for each meter I descend, I will travel 15 meters out. And I can use that knowledge to calculate my glide ratio. I'm passing 6,000 just now, indicator airspeed mode. And that means from this altitude, I can glide 15 nautical miles. So let's use that to our benefit. I also see Dubai Airport. I will turn down in. I think I have a good distance out. It's important not to go too close, but of course, don't go too far out either. Feel inside. Dubai has two runways. They are a bit staggered. I'm intending to land on runway 1-2 left. As a backup, I have 1-2 right, and we have an emergency, so tower will clear both runways and airspace around us, so we have everything for ourselves. When we lost so many systems, for example, I have something called TLU, initial fault, I have to select low speed, that controls the rudder movement. So I set it to low speed. It takes a little time to move. If I don't do that, the rudder will barely move on landing. And I have limited control already. So therefore, it's important. Now the light went out, and I am good with the rudder. I don't have main hydraulic pumps. They are gone. So what I do is, for the flaps, it's powered by the blue hydraulic. I have an extra pump on my side. And let's see. Still at 4,000, but I cannot go too far out. The airport is 5 miles away. I turn a little. The simulator has limited visibility on the behind. In aircraft, you can see further than in the sim. Now I see part of the airport. I can also cross the center line. I can make S turns and do the best out of it, but I need space for that. And back to the blue hydraulic system for the flaps. I will set this light fell over. Let's see if I can get it back. Maybe that works. Okay. Then I can set flap 15. See, let me turn a little more. Just so I see the airport. That's quite important. 3,400 feet. Anchor glide, 5 miles. Sorry, 7 miles. It's time to turn. Crosswind. There it is. Oh, still high. Still high. That's good. We can set flap 15. I run the pump and select flaps. The pump runs for 30 seconds. It's a backup for the blue system. For the landing gear, there is no hydraulic backup. And I will, let's see, I will fly manually. And let's see, I think I can turn fine now. 2,700, 5 miles, I am high. Landing gear down. Pull this handle. I can also make S turn. don't need a flight director. Set it standby. A little fast now. Let's see, let's turn towards the runway again. The landing gear will, of course, result in a lot of drag. I should have the lever down, then the red lights go out. That's bad there, isn't it? Am I safe altitude? Yes. Okay, flaps 30. Could even reach the right runway, but I'm okay. If I land touchdown middle of the runway, it's a good landing. I never want to get short, right? So now we have flaps 30, gear down, yaw damper goes off. That's quite important. Okay, this will be a long landing. Just relax, don't panic. It's a long runway. And I don't have normal brakes, but I have I can need an aux pump for the nose steering, and I have emergency brake. Parking brake lever set to emergency after touchdown. So for nose steering, I activate the blue hydraulic pump now. And speed is good. The center line. And touchdown. Emergency. Oops. It veered off. I don't know why. But okay. I take the nose steering. Except for that strange behavior after touchdown, it worked well. Okay. We stop here and wait for the tow truck. So that was an emergency landing, not perfect, but good enough. And if you have flown gliders before, that will be a good benefit. I haven't done that for 20 years or so. Okay, as usual, a big thank to the supporters of the channel. And to all of you, thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day and happy landing. Mm-hmm.